This is problem number 20 of GATE 2017. Consider the system with input-output relation yn equals to 1 plus minus 1 to the power n xn. The system is option A invertible and time invariant, option B invertible and time varying, option C non-invertible and time invariant, and option D non-invertible and time varying. Okay, now we have these equations. Okay, now for say x1n input, we have y1n output, and that is equals to 1 plus minus 1 to the power n x of 1n, right? And y2n is equals to 1 plus minus 1 to the power n x2n, right? Now if I take, say, let x2n is equals to x1n minus k, right? Now if this is x2n equals to x1n minus k, we are just shifting the time or sample of x1. Now if I put this in equation number, this y2n is equals to 1 plus minus 1 to the power n into x1 n minus k, right? Now if I write y1 n minus k, so we need to replace the n by n minus k, so this will be 1 plus minus 1 to the power n minus k into x1 n minus k. So we can observe that y2n is not equals to y of n minus k. For y x2, for the input x2n is equals to x1n minus k, but the output corresponding to that inputs are not same. So for from this conclusion, we can say that the system is time varying. Okay, so the system is time varying. Now if say x1n is equals to delta of n minus 1. Okay, now if I put this, we have y1n is equals to 1 plus minus 1 to the power n delta of n minus 1, right? Now we know that we know that function of a into delta of n minus a is equals to function of a delta of n minus a. Using this property, we can write the y1n is equals to 1 plus minus 1 to the power n means n minus a means 1. So this will be 1 plus minus 1 to the power n is equals to 1, when fn, we are replacing fn by fa, so this will be 1 into delta of n minus 1, and that is 1 minus 1, that is equals to 0, right? And if I take x2 is equals to n minus 3, say. Okay, so what will be y2? y2n is equals to 1 plus minus 1 to the power n delta of n minus 3, and from this properties again, we can write 1 plus minus 1 to the power 3 delta of n minus 3, right? And that is 1 minus 1 again, and that is equals to 0. So we can conclude that for different inputs, delta n minus 1 for x1n, and for x2n we use delta n minus 3. For different inputs we get the same output, that is 0 and 0. And if I do the same for n minus 5, n minus odd numbers, we will get the output equals to 0. So we can conclude from this solution that it is non-invertible. So the correct option will be non-invertible and time varying. So the correct option is option D, right?